Oh my goodness, you guys. You already know by the title what we're talking about, but Pat McGrath just shared her Bridgerton collection number 2, and I'm here to talk about it, tell you my thoughts, my first impressions. I don't have the collection, I don't have the makeup. I'm going to be buying it with you guys, but I have some thoughts about this collection. Honestly though, I haven't thought too hard about it. I just did a quick once through, and then I was gonna save most of my thoughts as they come so you can kind of see like a second impression of my thoughts. But we did know a Bridgerton part 2 was coming. I didn't realize it was going to be a whole collection. If you're not familiar with Pat McGrath, she actually launched a Bridgerton collection in, what was it, January? It was not too long ago. So I am so surprised to see an entire part 2 collection. Now, it makes sense. This collection is for the season 2 on Netflix. Pat said it was inspired by season 2, but it's just interesting how close the first collection and second collection were. I wonder if the first collection was supposed to launch earlier, but maybe with the supply chain, because it came very late after season 1, and then immediately 2 months later, the season 2 collection came. But I'm not mad though. Okay, you guys know I love Pat McGrath and I love Bridgerton, so I'm excited nonetheless. I actually am currently reading the second book in the series before the show actually comes on March 25th. So many of you guys told me that it was your favorite book in the series. It's very interesting reading the book versus the show. I love the show because it's so visually appealing, but it's nice to read the book and then be able to compare. I think I like the show better, but only because the show is so pretty to look at. Anyways, no exact date as to when the collection is going to launch, but you can sign up for VIP early access, which I suggest that you do, because who knows, the collection didn't sell out super fast with the first Pat McGrath Bridgerton collection, but I believe within the day, they did eventually end up selling out of everything. So if you go to the Pat McGrath website now, you can actually take a look at everything, and that is what we are going to do together. You can see the theme of the packaging is pink. For the last collection, it was a baby blue, which made a lot of sense. I'm a pink girl. I'm excited about this. I'm very interested to see how it compares to season 2, because the blue was very clearly from the Bridgerton family blue. Daphne always wore blue, so I want to see where the pink comes in. So let's take a look here at everything. So it says, prepare for the divine debut of collection 2. I'm gonna move over to the side so you can see the photos, and everything is super decked out in pink. I love it. That is so beautiful. So instantly you'll see a baby mothership, a six panner, the belle of the ball. And I have to say, this reminds me a lot of the first palette. It has a pop of blue and it has those two pinks, the middle pink at the tops, that baked gelée. This looks like the first palette. Maybe a little bit brighter in pink, and then you have Pat McGrath's signature gold. So I'm gonna tell you right now, I don't think I'm that excited for this palette. I was hoping for something different and exciting from this, and I said the same thing about the last Bridgerton palette, in that I liked it because I was a Bridgerton fan, but the color story wasn't anything to write home about, and I'm feeling the same about this as well. I wonder if there's gonna be any new formulations here. Yeah, especially with the bee embossed shade and then the Lady Whistledown embossed shade, those look almost exactly like the first palette, maybe slightly different in tones, but they're both the same color family, so nothing new and exciting there. It says on the website, the passion for beauty is infinite, celebrating season 2 of the Shondaland and Netflix smash hit Bridgerton, blah 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 blah. Limited edition palette presents 6 Regency era eyeshadows in 5 futuristic finishes: a velvety plum matte, a peony pink satin matte eye blush, so you're able to use that on the cheek. She had that in the first palette. Luminous pale rose gold highlighter, so she's advertising this as both a face and eye palette. And an electrifying pair of sparkling astral shades. We love to see astral shades though, so that is exciting. In pastel aqua metallic and divinely deepened chartreuse. So if you go to the bottom of the page, there is actually kind of a guide as to how they would recommend you use the shadows. You'll see Forever Charmed looks really dimensional, but it's a gold, so it's not that exciting. And Darling Dandy is also a dimensional shade. Oh, but Diamond's Desire also looks very pretty. You're gonna be able to get a pretty look with this, but it's pink. There's a lot of pinks. So yeah, it's not that exciting of a color story to me. I see a little bit of Divine Rose 1 and 2 in here, especially with that pop of gold. So I think if you're not a fan of Bridgerton, if you have the first palette, this is probably, before I have it in my hands, I'm going to say you can probably pass on this. The outer packaging is exactly the same, just the pink. So yeah, I'm a little let down by that color story. It's a little warmer, but nothing exciting. There was another opportunity to do something different, and we played it safe once again. So yeah, that's that. So this is very new though, so you know I'm excited about this. This is the Blushing Delight. It looks like a face palette. I have mixed feelings about this as I'm looking at it. I'm excited because it looks different. It looks like we have a new blush formula. Looks like kind of a baked gelée. I'll read down the details as I scroll to see. So I like it because it's new, but it also is kind of cheap, right? Something about it just seems not luxe. The fact that it looks like it's in cardboard packaging, I don't know, it looks kind of teenage makeup-y to me. I'm excited about it. I'm excited for these new formulas. The packaging, I love the design, but if it is cardboard, I don't know. The shades look really pretty though. It looks like you're definitely going to have to like pinky shades on the cheeks. There's one that's slightly a peachy pink, but the other two blushes are in the pink family. And then you have a highlight in Champagne Venus. And these seem to be all new shades. I haven't heard of these from Pat McGrath before. Let me read a little bit about the formulations. This is a talc-free baked formula. So we've never had baked products from Pat McGrath for the cheeks. So it's a new formula. So I will definitely be picking this up so that I can test out this formula. But I know a lot of people aren't going to like this because of the packaging, because there's so much empty space as well. So let's see. It stars three baked blushes complemented by a heavenly heart-shaped melange highlighter. Let's see. Each silky feather light formula glides on, blending and building with exquisite ease. So we have brand new formulas, brand new colors here. I will be trying it, but I'm not as in love as I was at first glance, because the longer I look at it, the more less luxe it looks to me. Hopefully the formulas are really good, but I don't know how big the packaging it is, but I don't like all the empty space either. I wish she made the product inside bigger. I don't know. What are your thoughts on that? It's just interesting because we've never had a layout like that. There also is the Satin Allure lipsticks. So the packaging is adorable. I don't think I'll be getting every color, but I love this packaging. So there are bows. It looks like there's three that are pink and then four that are blue. Yes, there are seven shades here. Nude Romantic 2 looks so good. So we have a cool neutral pink nude, Nude Romantic 2. Veiled Rose is a mid-tone mauve pink. Infatuation is a vivid cool tone berry pink. Elson 5, that shade already exists, so I won't be buying that. It's just in the limited edition packaging. And I might be missing these. Some of these might exist, so I'm just speaking only on what names I'm recognizing. Venusian Peach is a light peachy nude. Negligee, a neutral pink beige. And then Entranced, a warm flesh rose. I will say, you guys, the colors look stunning. As I'm looking, I like want to pick up every single one except for Elson 5. They're very rosy, neutral, pinky kind of tones, which is what I'm really into. And I love that little bow detail. I'm kind of tempted by these. I bet you they are going to be gorgeous. These are a satin shine finish, medium buildable coverage, cool and warm shades, flatters all skin tones. I want these. Pat McGrath doesn't have my favorite lipstick formula, but she still has a really great one, and I'm loving the looks of these colors. And oddly enough, of what we've talked about thus far, I'm probably the most excited for the lipsticks. We also have a scintillating diamond body shimmer. It looks like you just pat it on. I don't normally wear products like that, so I'm not as excited. There's two shades, a pale moon, which is a platinum pink, and then golden majesty, which is a neutral yellow gold shimmer. This will be $52. That's actually quite expensive. The packaging again looks like that cardboard packaging. It looks nice, and in this case for this product, I don't mind it. It's that quad that I feel a little weird about. I think I will pass on this. I don't think I want it. It's just not a product that I will be inclined to grab for, but it might be really nice over the décolleté, but not something that I feel the need to have. And then the last product in this collection is the Legendary Wear Velvet Kohl Eyeliner. I will be getting this just to try it out. It's gonna be $28. I mean, it just looks like a Kohl liner to blend out. I wonder how well it will set. Not particularly excited about this, but just want to try it because I'm curious about the formula. I love a nice Kohl. It looks like the bottom pulls out and there's a sharpener on top. Yeah, this was pretty nondescript. It's not that exciting. It's interesting that she put this here. The girls in Bridgerton don't really wear too much makeup. They don't wear too much deep smoky eye. I'm not mad at her for putting out this product, but I don't know that it goes with their makeup. They just don't wear makeup like that in the show, but whatever. I mean, she could have used this formula in her line, I suppose. It says it's a hyperpigmented velvet Kohl eyeliner inspired by season 2. I wonder what inspired that. Whatever, I'm gonna get it. I'm interested. I forgot to mention the price of the palette. So the quad is $60. That's not bad considering you're getting 4 products, but again, that's $60 to what looks to be a cardboard packaging, but we'll see. And then the eyeshadow palette's going to be $65. Am I excited about this collection? I am. I definitely am. I'm a little let down by the color story of the eyeshadow palette, though I'm sure it's going to be beautiful. The quality is going to be good. It's just not something that I need. The Blushing Delights quad, I'm very, very curious about. I'm not liking it as I look deeply into it, but if the formulas are good, I could jump on board pretty quickly. The lipsticks are actually what I'm most excited about. The tones to me look absolutely stunning. I might have to buy almost all of them. The Diamond Body Powder, I'm gonna pass on. It's just not something that I will use, but if you're into that type of product, it's in gorgeous, gorgeous packaging. I'm sure you will feel quite luxe putting that on every day. And then the Velvet Kohl Eyeliner, a bit odd that she included this in the collection, but I mean, I'm not mad about it. If you scroll down onto the main page, Nicola Coughlin, or Coughlin, sorry if I'm mispronouncing that, she looks stunning. So it says the new Belle of the Ball, and I'm happy to see that she is the face of this collection. I'm gonna assume she's wearing products on her eyes. It looks like they use some of the Kohl liner and then the gold all over her lid. I mean, this look is stunning. I want to do a look like that. I am into this. She said this palette is so gorgeous. It's so pigmented. It's so sparkly. I'm obsessed. Okay, you got me sold, Nicola. But yeah, I'm gonna leave you guys the link down below and you can scroll through the website. There's lots of behind the scenes and little tidbits of information here. Yeah, it's very interesting timing to me given how close it was to the first collection. I mean, this collection coming out makes sense at this time. We're like 2 weeks or so away from the premiere of season 2. So I'm excited to see how the two correlate, the show and this collection. I don't know, we'll see. I will be ordering a lot of it, so make sure you're subscribed to my channel to get my review on it. I'm hoping the palette is extra special in person, because that's the thing with Pat McGrath. Many times I've been underwhelmed by what I've seen online, and then you get it in person and you feel a lot better. So let me know your thoughts on this collection down below. Will you be picking anything up? Are you going to watch Bridgerton season 2? And with that being said, that's all I have for today's video. Keep an eye out. I will be reviewing this. I also have my pastel palette coming tomorrow from Natasha Denona, so I will be reviewing that as well. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.